Thank you.
I just stepped in. Thank you. Audio check, 1, 2, 1, 2. Are we live? Good afternoon, everybody. Kia ora koutou. Welcome, everybody, to the Alpine Ice Sports and Entertainment Center. My name is Matt Chavez.
Gentlemen.
We're here today to
Thunder,
call the game
Gregory,
between the
Tristan
Canterbury Red Devils
and, Lewis up front,
and the
Starling,
West Auckland
Ben
Admirals.
Is a deep pairing.
An interesting series coming up because the...
The series
between these two is going
to, the room to
work
shoot
out
it.
The middle of
and
the table for the most part.
That was a soft
Red
goal.
Devils
James
managed
Warren
to
not be happy with that one.
Escape
yeah,
Dunedin with
that
all 6 points
and,
last weekend.
You don't want to see the replay.
And after their opening weekend,
behind the play with the puck.
Well,
no,
let's say it's not a great situation. They ended up with nothing coming out of their series with Queenstown. But last weekend has put them all the way up, virtually tied second in the table.
By Regan Wilson,
in a good
stood
spot
on the puck
for the NZIHL playoffs
the
coming up. So
to retreat.
This will be a telling match between the two sides here. The Admirals
misses the man, and Red Devils will pick it up. Oh, turnover! In well, right, he's got a chance. Oh, he scores with a beautiful backhand.
What a goal! What a goal!
That was a phenomenal backhand move. That was amazing.
I'll be broadcasting from the DJ booth across from the cameras. This will be the first time in 7 years I've seen the game from the other side of the ring.
Messy over there in the corner. It comes back to Allen, though. Allen gets a shot away. It's through. It's tapped. And it's in the back of the net. Dylan Devlin on the far side puts it home off a rebound. And the air cannons are going off here in Dunedin Ice Stadium.
There's plenty of noise coming from the crowd too after that one. I think they're getting pretty excited for the rest of the night now.
Yeah, that's an equalising goal, making it 2-2 late in the first period. Both love their ice hockey. Great pass to Billy Sheard. Can he make a shot? He gets the backhand. Got another one on, but Carey has the puck. Gonna have a shot there. Gets it low on Moore, who makes the save. And the puck comes out to the corner. Shot on and into the pads of Moore, who covers that one up before anything can happen in front of him. And then Dylan Devlin to tie it all up. It's Apps. He's got Joe Wall going to the net. Joe Wall's going to get there, and he goes to the backhand. Great save by Moore. Oh, but Joseph Orr tidies up the loose puck and puts it in the net. 3-2 Red Devils.
That was great sticking with it for Orr. He got this, got the shot off and it got saved, and then he followed it up by banging the rebound home.
Back to Stiley. Banks it up to Enright. Skates back down low. Gets a puck stolen. And poked away from James Moore. Quick to react there in the loose puck. Trailing by one goal at the moment. Looking to get on the table with some points. They can come away with a win tonight. Sheard gets taken off the puck. It's there for Allen. He shoots. Oh, yes! It's a goal from Allen. Hit the back post behind Reason and bounced into the net. Nichols looks across to Carey, back to Eden, whose shot is deflected. It's a backhand shot. Oh, and it's a goal for the Phoenix Thunder. Wonderful passing from the Red Devils, and the pressure is finally told. They go up 4-3.
So did Thunder have a player in the box then?
Well, they must have.
Yes, there was a penalty on the board there. So
it must have been delayed. Must have been delayed game. What are we? What are we paying attention to? Nothing. Obviously, we're missing everything.
To to you guys and to Matt Harrop that organised the trips for you guys to come down. It's always a good time when you guys come down and play a bit of beer league hockey with us. So
Red Devils counterattack. It's Reese. Centres that towards Eden, and he can't get a shot off. And it's cleared out by the Thunder. Chris Eden trying to beat Blair. He does. He gets, trying to go to the forehand. Oh, no. And Moore has let the slippery goal in as Chris Eden spun around and fired it as he skated past the net. Eden shoots it high over the goal. Red Devils looking for that empty netter. Josh Lowe will put it into the zone, and it's all over here in Dunedin, folks. Red Devils come to Dunedin and take the candy away from the Thunder. 2-2 for the Red Devils.
Well done for the Red Devils. They showed up and played some great hockey.
And we're underway here. Hopkinson wins that back for Tula. Admirals doing well to get sticks in the lanes. Kozak will put one on net, deflect and scores! Richie Hopkinson on the redirect from the point from Kozak, and the Swarm take a 1-0 lead here early. As Vespa try to get around Tula. Vespa with it again, centering feed, shoot! And a good save as the net comes off its moorings once again. Scott Henry with a golden opportunity. Here he is, speak of the devil, it's Polozov. And he's denied. As Commons will leave that on for Andy Hay, who loses it, and Henderson, shoots it straight into the goalie. Those two are well accustomed. Oh, Kozak, great hit there. Kozak with it again, and a pad save there by Chubba. So tries to get the Swarm fans to start a chant. Mawson with it. He puts one on. Chubba didn't really see that as there was a lot of traffic in the way. As Hayward Jones clears that for the Admirals. Henderson gone in net. Oh, redirect. But straight into the arms of Harrison. As Hopkinson finds Johnson, dangerous from this position, only could get a backhand on. And here's Polozov. He's got Whitson Lee in the middle. Puck didn't go out, and quick shot on by Sandoy. Chubba only saw it at the last second. Here's Johnson, finds Kozak, finds Mawson. Mawson shoots, and a great effort there by Regan. Would have been a dandy of a goal if he got all the way through there. As Ellis puts on a nice hit there on Gavin Puckett. And Atwell comes and gives a hit on Hendo. Physicality starting to pick up again, and that will do it here for the second period. And one there by Chalice. Mawson pressured there by Moses. Harrop with a quick shot. A rebound in front. It was sitting there in the crease for a second as Tula had to come and clean up. Good hit there by Mason Kinney. 2-1 though. Hopkinson finds Kozak, back to Hopkinson. He misses it. Oi. Here's Hendo. Dagsy rips one on. Stick save there by Harrison. As Hendo will pass it on to Hayward Jones. Get it back. Try to find Hayward Jones again, but it was in front. Shot on. Rebound in front of the net. Another shot by Hendo. Harrison once again standing strong, seeing it all the way. Gives it back to Daig. And couldn't get the puck out as three Swarm guys corralled him. Here's Commons, shoots, and a good pad save there by Chubba. As Chalice will find Daig.
if he hadn't left it right to me. And we're underway. The Admirals grab the puck early and get it through neutral, and they're going to try their old dump and chase. That's going to go for an icing as Chris Eden is first to the puck, and we'll go all the way back over to the West Auckland Admirals defensive end. Face off in the defensive end for the Admirals, and Joe Orr still out there to take that one against Chalice. Chalice wins that, brings it back, and the Admirals work to get it out of their end. Tripped up a little bit. We're going to have an early call. Regan was tripped, and I think that was by no intention tripped by Joe Orr, but Joe Orr is going to sit for 2 minutes. And that is going to bring the first special teams for the afternoon. This time it's going to be for the Admirals on the power play. 2 minutes on the board with just 17 seconds into the game. And 5-on-4, the advantage for the team in blue. They win the faceoff. That puck on the sideboards, they continue to fight for it. And the Devils get a hold of it, get it out, and clear it to neutral. Maxim holding on to it. And it's thrown in and behind Reason's net. Taking a look, and that goes out to neutral. Daigle to collect it for the Admirals. And a little bit of a forecheck by Mathis and Graham there, but not too much. They're just going to hold on to it and wait for it to come in. Devils chase it and get a hold of it first, but then that gets thrown back out to the blue line by the Admirals and goes all the way down. And that goes out to neutral, the Admirals with it. And as they fight for the puck, it's Chamberlain with it behind the net. He goes behind Reason, holds on to it in the low corner. He's in the near the goal line. Good shot by the Admirals. That was a quick switch of the play here, and then did not quite get onto Reason's onto the net. There really, he just had a large spot open for him and didn't get the target. And we continue on with the power play. Chamberlain with it, out in front, turned over to Eden immediately and sending it right back down. 24 seconds to go on the power play. Out to neutral. Sistrone throws it in behind the net. That's carried to the far corner, or the near corner on the camera. I got to get used to that one. Orr's about to come out. Sistrone pushing it forward, and the power play is over. Reason knocks it away with his stick, held on by the Admirals. The Admirals hold on to the puck. They're widening the umbrella a little bit, but can't quite get it in on net. And the Devils hold on to it. That's Eden breaking out on the right side. He's going to flip it forward off the goalie's mitt, and a line change for the Devils coming up. The Admirals holding on to possession. Sistrone with a turnover. And another big turnover to Graham. Graham's going to take a shot. That gets deflected. That was a good save off the goalie's glove up into the netting. Kirkham Chaba. oh, man, I've got to hang on 1 second here. Kirkhamagos flips it up into the netting. So a faceoff coming. And the Admirals break out after that faceoff. Ellis with it. He sends it in, but that's turned over immediately. Back out by the Devils. Out to neutral ice. And sent right back in to chase that down. Brown with it. And that gets moved back out to neutral. Graham with it at the red line. He's going to walk it in for a moment. He couldn't get anything on the shot. Walked in, and it was kind of off the edge of his stick there. Perver holds it in. It's going to get back to Mathis, and a shot in off the shoulder, but that just hits the pipe and bounces just outside. But a really good opportunity for the Devils to start with. And that's kind of slapped in there just onside. No icing coming, and the Devils are going to switch up some personnel. And the Admirals hold on to that for a while. Daigle with it. He actually did a bit of a toe drag there. Raisin had to be on his game in order to keep that away. Turned over, and that's going all the way back behind Kirkomagus's net. The Admirals working to get it out of their zone. That was up on the dasher, but it stayed down. Daigle's going to get it in onside. He gets a pass interrupted. And Lowe pushes it to the side. Goes out to Reason's net, hits the side, and bounces around. And Nichols is going to toss it all the way out, and the Devils are going to get a change. Talon with it. He dumps in. Pretty obvious situation for both teams looking for dump and chase this afternoon. Taylor Kennedy with it. He gets that knocked off his stick, but goes back to neutral, collects it, and looks to get the remaining offensive opportunity. But instead, they flip it, switch up, and the Devils get started on their offense. Low with it. Deflected into the corner. Big presence by the Admirals behind the net, and they do grab onto the puck and break out with it. And back out to neutral, Chris Eden with it. See Eden holding onto it in the near corner. He's looking for a pass. Gets it out to the Keokope, right out on the point. That doesn't quite get through. There's a penalty coming. Not sure what this is. It looked a bit slashy, but it's actually a hook. And we'll see who goes for this. It was on the Devils. That's why I didn't see it. The slashy thing came from the Admirals. But 2 minutes on the board. That's Joe Orr going for the hooking penalty for the Red Devils. Face-off won by the Admirals, and they hold that into the zone for just a moment. That gets shot in off Reason's net. Ellis with it. He's not able to hold on to it, but he skates by and pushes and then re-corrals it. Out to Daigle on the point, off to the other side, and the cycle continues for the Admirals. Ellis with a shot. That was off the shoulder and up into the glass. Daigle with a drag. And a goal. Vesper with it. The Daigle shot goes off of Reason. Nobody there to take Vesper at the body, and he gets a close-in shot and gets the first goal of the afternoon with
Cycle
Reason beat on the left
the
side. 1-0 the score. Admirals on
Ellis
top.
Ellis with a shot. That was off the shoulder and up into the glass. Daigle with a drag.
Looks like we may have some audio problems,
guys. And a goal,
guys.
Vesper with it.
Let you know, we do understand what's going on. It's getting worked out here. And we're back underway just that quickly. 1-0 the score. The Admirals with the early lead here in the Alpine Ice here in Christchurch, New Zealand. Saisho knocks it in behind Kirkomagos. He goes and collects it and gets it out, but the defense not able to get it out for the Admirals right away. And that flip is going to go for an icing call, so the Red Devils are going to get a change and an opportunity coming up here in the offensive end. Hayden Bull to take that one for the Devils. Doesn't get it quite off the face off. The Admirals are going to be able to break out here. 5-on-5 as we go into the second, 13 minutes to go in the first period. And the Admirals doing a good job of controlling the offense so far. Had more opportunities and more zone time thus far. And as that gets knocked around in the corner, Chris Kennedy trying to hold it in on the point but can't. The Devils do their best to get it out, and the third line hops over the boards and gets the fresh legs out for the Devils. The Admirals break out, and they get to neutralize, looking to gain the zone. They do for just a moment, but that's turned right back around as they get a defensive change in. Well, that's turned over. Matt Graham going to take it into the corner himself. Four players out in front looking for a pass. Perver able to get it for just a moment, but then it gets toe-dragged right back out behind him, sent all the way down for icing, and the Devils are going to get another face-off opportunity with no line change coming up for the Admirals. Good opportunity here for the Red Devils to get some offense going here with about 7.5 minutes gone in the first. Joe Orr to take this one. He wins that one. Gets caught in the linesman's skate for just a moment. And play continues. The Admirals trying to get it out. Didn't quite right away, but it does work its way out. And right back into the Admiral zone. Turned over. Pass right out in front to Orr, then to Eden. Eden's going to get a shot off. Got a good shot, but not quite on target. It looked like it just missed to the left. Passed around and collected by the Admirals. That was an interesting back pass. Didn't quite – it was almost on target, which is not a good thing if you're a defender. And that's sent around by Dan Nichols to get things started. The Admirals hold on to it behind Kirkomagus's net. Turned over again to the Devils. Another good opportunity here by the team in red. Out to the point, shot in. Trying to get something through. It sat for just a moment in a dangerous spot in the slot, but nobody home for the Devils on the other side of the ice. So that goes out to neutral, and everybody resets. Joe Orr trying to get a hold of it. And then got knocked out to the other left side. Chalice with it. And then that's going to go for an icing. Hands were up pretty quickly on that one. They are going to look to get ice. So the couple of Red Devils got off the ice, but I think they're going to be recalled here as the Admirals get an offensive zone face-off here coming up with 11 minutes to go in the first. I'd like to thank our sponsors, Spark Business Hub, Cedra Express, Majors Contracting, and we'll get to the other sponsors here in a little bit. Faceoff coming in the defensive zone for the Devils. The Admirals win it. Shot in on Reason again. Not too difficult there. Just knocked away by the paddle. And the Admirals hold on to it in the corner. Trying to cycle around. There's a penalty coming up here. Not sure what that was, but it's likely on the Devils given when it was called. And we'll see who that goes on, but... Nobody leaning towards the penalty box yet to skate that one out. Not sure. I could be wrong on this one. We'll see how this goes. But high sticking a call. That was against the Admirals. So I did miss that one because of when it was touched up. Frazier Ellis is going to go off for 2 minutes. And that's going to be a big deal for the Red Devils to get an opportunity to get one more on the board. Perver to take the face off. Worked around, shot in behind the net, missed the goal. Cycles to the near boards, or the far boards on the, as far as the camera sees it. A little bit of a tangle into the net there. Perver with it down low, shot in front, and that's deflected just over Kirkomagus's crossbar. And that is held in. Graham had it for just a minute. He's going to have to pass back to Tappan. And he's going to go collect. The Admirals stay out on the ice mostly, just one change. And the Devils try to break out. A little bit of a forecheck holds things up. Daigle a little bit high, but for the most part, not really causing too much of a problem. Just Chamberlain getting in there and holding on to the puck for just a moment. And the Devils try to come in on the opposite side of the ice. Matt Graham trying to get a hold of that puck. Doesn't quite get there. That's passed across and into the sideboard. Back across the ice again. That's Eden taking a sweep at, or Graham taking a sweep at it. Out to the point.
Yeah, shot in. Kirkomagus's glove hand. That didn't look like it was quite on target. But Liam Dallimore with a wrister. Didn't quite get everything on it, but it was a dangerous shot enough to get play stopped. And faceoff coming for the Devils in the offensive zone here. 37 seconds to go on the power play. 5-on-4 for the Devils. And they hold in the puck in their zone, in the offensive zone, for just a little while longer, trying to get something set up. And that puck gets stalled in the corner. Pushed around. Eden's going to collect it in the corner on the opposite side. Nifty little pass over to Orr. Orr's got it right out in front. An opportunity, low, not able to do anything with it. I'm not sure if they're going to call that as being in the crease. He was awfully close. No, it came off the moorings there, so play stopped. 8 seconds to go in the power play. And the Devils trying to do something in order to get an opportunity before this power play closes out. Hayden Bull to take that, and he wins it off to Nichols. Long shot, low in, looking for a deflection, none coming, and the penalty's over, out to Regan. Regan's going to collect the goal, or the puck right away, move around towards Reason. He's going to take a shot, go around the goal, didn't get anything on it, or collects it. He's going to get bumped off the puck for just a moment, stays in the zone for the Admirals. And puck eventually collected, but kicked around, and then still onside for the Admirals, doing a very good job of holding on to it and disrupting play. Nichols knocks it up, doesn't realize it's there. Puck's on the stick of one of the Admirals players, cannot get a shot off, but a big opportunity. It was Daigle with it. He couldn't quite get anything over Reason. Close to being 2-0, but the home team getting away with it. Now, that's flipped out by Nichols. It hits the netting, so no delay there. And the puck being returned to the linesman. Aotearoa Gaming Trust, Fishers, Spinorama, and Access Solutions, thank you all for being fantastic sponsors of the 2022 Canterbury Red Devils. We couldn't do it without you. Thank you very much. Puck dropped and won by the Devils in the defensive end, but sent around. No clear possession yet. And still not out. The Devils doing what they can to work the puck out of their zone, but they haven't been able to do it for a while here. And that's behind the net. Kicked out and held in on the point. Once again, that's a shot. That actually, I'm not sure that it hit the post, but I certainly heard a bit of a ting there. I think it was the stick of Reason that did that. And a funny bouncer coming in on Kirkomagos. Who was that? That was Kaluzny not able to really get anything on that, but more dangerous than it needed to be on a very rolling puck. A warm afternoon here in Christchurch relative to things. Almost 10 degrees, so it's going to be a little bit rolly and bouncy out there on the ice. Face-off coming, and one. Eden takes a shot, is off target, bounces behind the net, and then makes its way out to neutral, recollected, and stolen right out in front. The Admiral's not onside, and they clear and get back. Puck's deep, but the Red Devils managed to get a hold of it and get out to neutral and not let that be too big of a problem. That is offside. I think it was offside to begin with. And we're going to play that. Well, no, it may have been an icing call, so that's going to go over to the defensive end for the Admirals. The Admirals doing a very good job of playing a solid road game thus far. No big mistakes. 13 minutes in, they've got a goal, they've got a lead, and they're doing a solid job of mistake-free hockey. But that face-off is lost. Chris Eden with another big slap shot, but that one doesn't get through, and it goes flying up into the air for just a moment. Monk with it. Goes back to Eden. He's passing it behind the goal, looking to get something right out in front. Can't do it yet. Having a hard time seeing a couple of these players through the glass here at the in the old DJ booth. That goes out to neutral. That gets passed back to Lowe, and the Red Devils reset. They're getting a couple of fresh legs out. That does a funny little spinner on the dasher, but then eventually falls into the into the wrong side of the ice and out into the stands, causing a stop in play. It's going to be a neutral ice faceoff. The Devils not really looking for, hasn't been a lot of offensive opportunity, but for the most part, that's been a strongly suggested by the Admirals, playing a very solid defensive game thus far. Pass through, I think that was just knocked away by Kirkamagos. Flipped in front. And passed back around, looking for, I think that's Sysho with it for just a moment. And a backhand wrister, not quite on target, but another dangerous opportunity. And I think that was Bull with it for just a moment. They knocked away by the Admirals. And out into neutral. Hopkins with it. He's going to pass it across the way. Knocks back in, but looking for a change. And the Devils do just that. Admirals looking to get in the offensive zone. They pass it forward, get it through. Collected by Hopkins, I think it is. Yep, George Hopkins. He is in a pile of bodies down there. Getting knocked around. It does actually come out, no stoppage in play, but then it's passed out to neutral and everybody's got to reset. That's offsides. They clear, and the Red Devils with the puck behind Reason's net. Looking to get it out. Another good pass across the way, and a fantastic hold by Reese, getting it in behind Magos' net, and that is an opportunity just kind of just sitting out there in the slot, but it didn't, nothing to it really. And the Admirals hold on to the puck. Up off the boards, over to neutral. Looks like it would go for icing. Just a matter of time here for Nichols to get close. And that is called for a stoppage in play. Icing is the call. 4:30 to go in the first period. Looks like the Devils are going to take the opportunity to put their first line out. Orr's going to take this. He wins it. Gets to Eden. Eden's going to go behind Kirkamagos. Look for a pass out to the point, but that's intercepted. And back and forth in neutral, they reset and get offside or onside. That's turned over for just a minute, but unable to be controlled. Low with it for just a moment, but Daigle gets by him. Daigle, one-man wrecking crew, and an early whistle as that puck was kicked aside. And the referee lost sight of it, so faceoff coming in the defensive end for the Red Devils. Just over 4 minutes to go here at the Alpine Ice Sports and Entertainment Center. Good action so far here in Christchurch. 1-0 the score. The Admirals ahead on what's been a tightly played, contested first period. A little bit of a housekeeping duties over on that side. Now the ice is clear. That was kicked around, and I think it was Chamberlain with it. He's going to get a wrister on it. Reason's going to hold on to it, and play stopped again. Face off. Ooh, that nearly took the lineman's head off, but luckily the puck goes whizzing right by the guy's mask and the play continues. That was a close one, as they say. Good hip check there by Eden on Chamberlain. Knocked him off his skates, but just temporarily, and a good clean hit. Didn't really look like a sense of frustration there, more just a, put your head down, you're gonna feel it. And Chamberlain's out there with his head on a swivel looking around. That's going to go for an icing call as the Admirals are trying to get off the ice, but not able to do so. So the Devils really have a good chance to get a tired line in a bad spot here if they can convert and win a faceoff and get something going as we look to close out the first period with an offensive flurry if they can pull it off. Faceoff one, but it goes out to neutral, so that's going to allow some of the Admirals to change up. And Regan able to hold on to it for just a minute, disrupting the flow for the Devils. Hopkins gets it out. Off to Poole. Kirko Magos knocking it just straight behind his net. A little bit of an interesting pass there, but it worked for the Admirals. And that's going to get deflected. No icing here. Played into the near corner. Out to the slot area. And that's going to go all the way down for an icing call against the Devils. Couldn't quite get that one to Sisho, but he was looking for it, couldn't touch it, and therefore icing coming up for the Admirals in the offensive end. Chalice to take that for the Admirals and wins it. Rister didn't quite get through. The Admirals hold on to it for just a little while longer as it's dug out on the sideboards. More opportunity for the Admirals. Nothing really on that shot, but a sweep and a throwing it around, and a stick goes flying. I think that was Hopkins' stick that just kind of left his hand there. It was looked almost like voodoo. Just coming flying right out. The Admirals doing a great job of holding on to the puck here. Kennedy looking for it. Taylor's going to take a long shot off. That misses high and left. That stays in. Ellis has it. His pass was intercepted, and the Devils are finally going to clear out to neutral here. Some tired legs as a shot goes in on Kirko Magos. Knocked away easily. It wasn't on target. It goes right back out to Chalice, but turned over. And the Devils are really on their back foot at the moment. Chalice with it as a turnover, and couldn't quite get anything going in the slot there. A good lifted stick probably made the difference with an opportunity there for the Admirals. The good defense for the Red Devils. And that puck goes into some snow and goes all the way through and is held on for a little bit more offense for the Devils. Minute 19 to go in the first. That gets knocked away. Brown to collect this one. He's got to skate hard as he beats Daigle back for the icing, which was Daigle's a quick skater, so that's a really good move. And that makes it icing for, against the Admirals, so the Devils are going to get a good opportunity here. With just 70 seconds to go in the first period, Perver wins that faceoff. Back to Lowe. Lowe's got it at the point. He's going to send it up to Graham. Graham goes behind the net looking for something going on here. And a shot in, and Kirko Magos is going to hold that one. A little bit of a spicy shot there, but easily held as that was a kind of torso level, easy shot to see coming in. And that keeps a zero on the board for the Devils. Looking to try to solve the puzzle here this afternoon. A couple of shots have been reasonable, but nothing really too dangerous thus far. As that one gets trickled in, Perver can't get anything on the back wrist, so the puck gets held up, and we're going to do it again. Faceoff won by Perver again. Devils holding on to it, going behind the net. That's back out to Lowe. Kind of close to the slot there and fought for. That's Graham kind of slashing his way through there, but couldn't hold on to it, and that's out to neutral. The Admirals get a hold of it out to Quigley. Quigley is going to skate in. Get double teamed. Oh, that's Perver that's getting double teamed over there. And the puck up against the board. Almost done here in the first, but that's a shot. That's deflected. It didn't quite go anywhere. Reason looking for it. He's kind of sliding behind. Out to neutral, and there's a stoppage in play with just about 3 seconds to go. And a penalty. Didn't see it. There is a trip call. Someone's going for tripping, and this is going to be against the Devils, if I'm not mistaken. 2 minutes for tripping Anton Perver. Probably the worst time you can take a penalty officially on the board. There's 2.8 seconds to go. So this is going to interrupt the start of the second period for the most part. Assuming that nothing really happens here. Hopefully not for the Devils, although there's a shot and Reason has to play it. The horn sounds. They're going to call this the period. I don't think they're going to put any more time on the clock, but a very, very strong shot by the Admirals. They end up getting a good offensive opportunity, although it is just 1-0. After the first period, a solid, solid road effort by the Admirals. And the Red Devils are going to have to play a little bit of catch-up as the teams go into the locker room for the first intermission. Hopefully the guys are going to show you the goal here. And then, yeah.
Okay, Ellis with a shot. That was off the shoulder and up into the glass. Daigle with a drag. And a goal. Vesper with the Daigle shot goes off of Reason.
We're going to take a little bit of a break.
Nobody there to take Vesper at the body.
Get back to you in about 10 minutes' time to bring you the action for the second period of hockey here at the Alpine Ice Sports and Entertainment Center. My name is Matt Chavez. We'll see you back here in just a few minutes.
Daigle with a drag. And a goal. Vesper with the Daigle shot goes off of Reason.
Kia ora koutou. Welcome back, everybody, to the Alpine Ice Sports and Entertainment Center. My name is Matt Chavez. We're going to bring you second period action here in just a moment between the West Auckland Admirals and the Canterbury Red Devils. Admirals up 1-0 after the first, and the Devils also doing a bit of a handcuff job on themselves with Perver being out. He's going to be a minute 58 in the penalty box as he took a tripping call with 2 seconds to go in the first. And he's just coming over the boards now and joining the scorekeepers on the side. So that's a special teams opportunity for the Admirals for almost 2 minutes of this first starting portion of the second period. We're going to get going here in just a moment. Face off at center ice. Chalice wins that one over Fontaine. Second line out there for the Devils, or a little bit of a mix-up, actually. Eden's out there, so we'll see if the coach has made any, not too many changes, just Fontaine out there at the moment. Admirals with the puck down deep, and they're going to walk behind Reason's net. Hold on to it. Try to set up some offense. They hold that in just barely. Chalice with it at the point. Flipped in. Nothing doing there. And Vesper looking troublesome right out in front of Reason. Nobody with a body on him yet, but can't get the puck to him. And as that gets cycled around, I'm going to try to walk that in a little bit out to the side. Chamberlain with it. And that's going to get knocked all the way down. And a little bit of a forecheck for the Devils, but not really. It looks like they're going to go for a line change. Fontaine just with a little bit of excitement as he got off the ice and made a good play there. Knocked by Kaluzny. And back out to neutral. 42 seconds to go on the power play. Graham with a good little forecheck here, holding some time off the Admirals. And that goes all the way forward. That's not going to be icing because that was playable, I think. No, it bounced over, so it is going to go all the way back. That was Josh Lowe with a hard-working icing call with 30 seconds to go on that power play to knock down some of the opportunity for the Admirals. Still 5-on-4, but a good way to kill that penalty there by some excellent hustle on the short or on the second period with the long benches. Face-off, Dodwell did not win that one, but they all kind of fall back. Sisha with it out on the left. Daigle's going to run it right up through the middle. Takes a wrister, doesn't get anything on it. Knocked away by Reason. Not too dangerous yet. They scrape away and try to get something on and in the slot and can't do it. That goes out to neutral. And that's going to close up the Admirals' opportunity, although they're going to get one more rip in. That's going to go up just over the glass and stop her faceoff. That was deflected. No problems there. So faceoff in the defensive zone for the Devils. But we're going back to 5-on-5. Thank you to Access Solutions, 2022 sponsor for the Canterbury Red Devils. Access Solutions Scaffolding, we really appreciate your help. Couldn't do it without you. And we've got some of your scaffolding up now, showing you these pictures. So thank you very much for your sponsorship. The Devils win that one. Hold on to it. That goes out to Fontaine. Can't quite get it out of the defensive zone. Kicked around. Sean Brown with it for just a moment. Then that goes back out to neutral. The Admirals are going to chase that down. Chamberlain looking for Quigley in front. Chamberlain going around the net. Holds high. Stays out at the point. Mason Kennedy, the former Red Devil, gets a hold of it, but deflected out by Eden, and that goes out into the stands for a faceoff. Not sure if that's going to be in or out of neutral, but we'll see shortly. And the Devils getting, that's going to be in their defensive zone, but the Devils are getting their sea legs under them here. Pardon the Admiral pun, but and the puck is returned by the anxious kids over there looking for a souvenir, but they did a great job. And that's going to held up for a second. Bad face-off of some sort. Linesman pointing in, so they're going to redrop this one. Perver and Chalice to take again. Not sure why that was stopped, but something wasn't right. Probably a bit of sneakiness behind them, getting a little too close and stopping it. This time the Perver wins it. And that was Dallimore trying to get it out to neutral. He gets it knocked away. That does go out to neutral to Dallimore. He's going to gain the zone. Move in on the right side. Takes a long shot in. Matt Graham skates close, but nothing doing. Kirk Komagos gloves it and stops play. With just under 3 minutes gone, for as much as the Devils have been down, they've been really hopping so far. Just a matter of turning this around instead of defensive opportunities to see if we can get some offense going. Admirals end up with that after a shot that was deflected in, out to neutral. And McLeish with it. That's knocked behind. Luke Tappan's going to hold on to that and try to wind his way through, and he does. Gets it to neutral. Nobody home. No icing, though, because it wasn't chosen to be played when it could have, so just line changes all around. Ellis is going to hold on to it as he gains the zone. Not sure he was onside there, but they continue play. And that's collected by the Devils. That ended up on Hayden Bull's stick. Knocked around a little bit. That's a bad turnover right out in front, looking for somebody in the slot. Couldn't do there. Ellis couldn't get a hold of it. Hayward Jones with a slapper. That was deflected off, and that's tipped, but that may go for icing as well. Looks like it is. It is indeed. And despite the deflection, it looks like it's going to come all the way back for the defensive zone for the Devils. Good action here in the first 4 minutes of the second period on both sides, but particularly the Devils picking up their defensive play and choices, doing a really good job thus far. Faceoff one and wristed in. I think it was knocked off of Reason's glove. Goes into the corner, nothing doing. And sent. Well, that was a great pass by Dodwell. Wrist her in and nothing doing. Kirkamaga seeing that most of the way. Who was that? Was that Sisho on that one? Not sure. Yep. Justin Sisho with the wrister. Didn't quite get it, pick his spot. But still a good dangerous shot for the Red Devils. And a faceoff coming in the offensive zone. That's knocked away and won by the Devils, but quickly turned over. There's going to be a chase on here. That's not going to go for icing. Yes, it is going to go for icing. That was a marginal play. The Devils going to be the recipients of that one. That was Monk chasing that down just in time and did the hustle there. Fisher Hockey and Spinorama, thank you very much for being sponsors of the 2022 Red Devils. We really appreciate your help, Fisher Hockey, and knowing how we go through equipment, always helpful. Admirals with it. I think Henry's got it at the moment. That's turned over. And turned over again. Harry Lowe had it for just a moment. He got some ice time and had a hold of the puck, but nothing going. Then Reason gets it flipped up. Not really a shot, just a pass in. He grabs it out of the air with his glove, but as the traffic gets close to him, he decides to hold on to it instead of passing it, and face-off coming in the defensive zone. Aotearoa Gaming Trust, sponsors of the 2022 Canterbury Red Devils, we do appreciate it. Used to know them as the Southern Trust, but we appreciate their sponsorship and their name change all at once. Oh, little bit of a wrister. That was a very interesting Caleb Chamberlain backhanded wrister. It was coming in, but it was coming so slow it looked like somebody was going to reach it and just eventually got in onto Reason, and he gloves it, so he stopped there. Face-off won by the Admirals, but collected by the Devils, and it gets turned around and not quite out to neutral yet. And everybody waiting to see who's going to grab the puck first. Ends up being the Devils. They get it out to neutral. Pass through, and that's deflected. Chamberlain with it right out in front. And a fantastic save by Reason. That's a play of the game so far. Chamberlain had that one on a string. Thought he had that five hold for all it was worth. And Chamberlain was so impressed, he goes up to Reason, taps him on the shoulder. A little good sportsmanship, saying heck of a stop there. Reason keeping it 1-0, thankfully, for the Red Devils. But another opportunity and a dangerous one for the Admirals. Do enjoy the Admirals' new shirts this year. They do look very sharp. And I'm sure that the Admirals fans, and I don't know if they've received a pretty warm welcome with it. They deserve it. They're sharp looking. And the team in blue holds on to the puck in the offensive end. Ellis does some circling and some holding. Passes it across the ice. That's in on Reason. It was kind of not a shot. It was just a proximity pass. And that's turned around on the boards. And the Devils having a heck of a time. Perver's doing what he can to dig it out, but can't do anything with it until that gets knocked around. The Admirals, Hayward Jones ends up keeping it in the zone still. And another extended effort by the Admirals in their offensive end. Must be tiring for the Devils at this point. Graham doing his best to keep that one available, but Hayward Junk just misses a pass, and that's going to get out to neutral just in time. Shot across through the paint, nothing doing, but a dangerous opportunity for the Devils. Just couldn't get anything to it. And turn right back around for the Admirals. Hayward Jones is going to gain the zone. Little couple of good moves off the stick. Throws it into the corner, Daigle to chase. And then flipped right back in front. And if it was a, it almost became an own goal. That was such a ripper of a back wrist shot. Henry's going to take a shot. That misses up and over the left shoulder, or the right shoulder of Reason. And that's turned over. Dodwell's with a pass there. That comes in on Kirk Gamagos. He's not really sure where it's at, and he's not sure where his stick is, but it got back out, and he's collected himself. Two-on-two option for the Admirals. Shot in on Reason. He kicks it aside, and back and forth we go with a couple of good opportunities. And Dodwell's going to gain the zone again, looking for a pass, but this is going to go into the corner. Behind Kirk Gamagos' net. And stuck around to Henry. Flipped aside. That was Mason Reese with it for just a moment. That's passed forward, looking for Eden. Eden sitting in his normal spot, looking for a feed there on the left point. Fontaine's going to have to chase that one down. And Eden gets a hold of it, and they're going to break out. Devils holding on to it for a long time. Back to Eden. He's going to go up the left side with some speed. He's going to go running in. He holds back. Drags three players with him, though. And Fontaine not able to get anything on that. That was a really good opportunity for Eden if he was able to get anything on that pass. But unfortunately, too much checking by the Admirals there. I think when you're the all-time points leader, you get a notification from everybody that when you've got the puck. I think even their phones light up at that point. Out of neutral still. The Admiral's working the puck. That bounces kind of hard off the board. Eden looking for it, then off to Orr. Admirals hold on to it, but they have to regroup. Cistrone with it. Paddled back, and Cistrone ends up with it at neutral again. He goes and gains the zone. Gets a heck of a hit by Nichols, but I'd say Cistrone actually the better of the two in that case. And then a hand pass being called as that was deflected off of one of the, I guess that would have been off of Cistrone's glove, although I can't say for sure it was his glove. And that's going to make it come out to neutral. Majors Contracting, a 2022 sponsor and longtime sponsor of the Canterbury Red Devils. We really appreciate your sponsorship. Majors Contracting, thanks again for helping us out this year. Face-off won by the Devils, but knocked right to neutral. And back and forth, that was Matt Graham had it for just a minute. It's turned over to Eden. Eden's looking for the pass. Graham not able to get anything on the shot. Back to Eden. Perver. That was Perver the whole time. Then Graham with the backhand. Perver holds on to it. Stays in the zone. Good opportunity for the Devils here, but they couldn't get anything going. And then a long pass out to Collins, or to Chalice, excuse me. And he gets a puck stripped away from him there. That was actually really good work by Josh Lowe. And Lowe and Perver hold on to it, and they're going to break this puck out. Although they couldn't get it out to neutral, looking for a long pass. Admirals continue with the offense. Wrister in on Reason, and I think that shot was strictly to get a face-off in the offensive zone, and it worked well for the Admirals. The score is still 1-0. The Admirals playing a very tight road game here in Christchurch with the Devils, and it's all going according to plan as far as they're concerned. Devils not able to crack the safe yet of Chaba Kirk Gamagos. Yeah, face-off is called for a replay here. I'm going to do it again. Yeah, I guess technically one by Lowe and the Devils, but it's kind of just knocked into no man's land. They cycle the Admirals. doing a good job with it, but it was passed out to the point. And they are chasing it down there. Dodwell's looking for a bit of a forecheck. Couldn't get a hold of it. And Hopkins doing his best to hold on to it. He made that go forward and did a good job defensively of making sure that that doesn't come in with speed. Back out to neutral. Bull had it for a minute, then off to Dodwell. That's passed over and around to Sisho. Sisho throws it behind the net. And Bull's going to try to keep that from coming out, but he can't. Nifty little pass by Daigle to Sirikov. And we continue play out of neutral. That's a good hit there by the Devils. I think that was Harry Lowe. No, that was Daniel Monk. We were getting a bit of a good push, and he's going to be rewarded with the puck here for just a moment. Devils still trying to get out to neutral. They do clear the zone finally. And that's kicked back out. Thrown right back in. Might go for icing here. Yes, indeed. See, that was Taehoon Kang with the long pass there to take the icing on that one. That's going to come all the way back. A little under 9 minutes to go here in the second period. Another face-off in the defensive end for the Devils, but they win this one. Hold on to it. Monk's got it. He's tripped down there. No call. The Admirals hold on to it. And recollected by the Devils. That's sent out to McLeish. McLeish is at center ice. He's going to tap it to the side. Admirals gain the zone. Sirikov taking it in again. Monk fighting really hard behind the net, but can't quite get any puck action there. So the Admirals hold on to a wrister right out in front. Dangerous shot, just not on target. It was good defense in the front, just couldn't get him to stop. And then that's turned over, and the Devils break out. 3-on-2 here. They're going to choose to go for a line change because they've been out there for a while. The Admirals regroup and look to get it out of the zone, and they do. Ellis has it up to Sistrone. He gains the zone. Shot in off target. And that continues to stay with the Admirals. Shot in wrister, and see, that was... Zach Steffen with the hard wrister in, but luckily Reason was able to see that the whole way in. Pretty easy save, but another offensive opportunity for the Admirals, who have gone from weathering the storm in the first 8 minutes of this second period to starting to take over just a little bit. Long pass out. This is going to be an opportunity. Shot and a score. Goal. And you know who that has to be. Chris Eden. On the outlet pass, three-liner Brought out to him. He gets it,
the storm
beats
the
Kirk Komagos, 1-1 the score. The Devils tie it up,
starting to take over
finally breaking
bit.
Open
pass
the,
out. This is gonna be an opportunity.
The scoring for them
Shot
and tying up this
score.
Afternoon's match.
The first
7:46 to go in the second, and this tight game just got even tighter.
A little bit. Long
as,
pass out. This is going to be an opportunity.
The league's leading scorer.
Shot and a score.
Scores in this 200th game.
Goal.
Some discussion about this faceoff. Chalice being told to put his stick down. He finally does. And that's tipped in. And let's see if there's a little pep in the step of the Devils here. As that gets deflected out. Funny bounce off the dasher. And apparently it was, not sure why the play was stopped there, but there was an opportunity for the Devils. It doesn't look like the goal's off its mount or anything. So we'll just say that's probably an early whistle, but it's staying in the offensive zone for the Devils. I've got Dallimore and Perver and crew on the two line ready to take this one. The captain takes it, doesn't win that face. That was a funny bounce. Admirals win that one. They get it out of the zone. They pass forward. Daigle's got it on the far side, near side on the cameras. Henry with it. That's going to break neutral, and the Admirals have to reset. A little bit of a forecheck, Dallimore being somewhat high, but not really affecting him too much. Henry gets a pass off to Daigle, but that gets intercepted, turned around. And it's going to dump in Dallimore to chase. goes past Mason Kennedy, and Kennedy helps get that one back out, and that's going to be turned over to Luke Tappan as he passes it around to Josh Lowe, and we get that back out to neutral. Kennedy to control. It's very strange saying Mason Kennedy holding the puck for the Admirals, but here we are, 2022, right? And then pass out to, let's see, that Luke Tappan had that one again. He managed to get a hold of it. There's a lot of movement this year in the league, inside the league. Dallimore with a wrister. That was held by Kirk Camagos. Wasn't really gloved, but again, out of sight, out of mind. Call a faceoff for the guy with the orange cuffs. And faceoff coming in the offensive zone for the Red Devils. just to finish that thought, a lot of in-club movement. We're happy to have Joe Orr here, of course. But, you know, just a lot of movement. It's been an interesting off season so far for the NZIHL. And I think it's done a lot of good things. Mason Reese with it. He's got it at the center line, passes it in. No icing there. He was just in front. Held in by Dodwell. That was deflected up and into the netting. I don't think that was really – Kirk Camagos stuck his leg out and just looked to get a deflection. I don't think he was expecting it to go over his head there. So another faceoff coming. Cedric Express, a 2022 sponsor and longtime sponsor of the Canterbury Red Devils. We do appreciate Cedric Express, their services and their sponsorship. Thank you again. Admirals win this faceoff. And they're holding on to it for just a bit. But that's kicked forward by Dodwell, kept in the zone for just a moment, and interrupts at least the flow of things for the Admirals. Some good defense going on with this second and third group out here for the Red Devils. Keeping their legs for sure this afternoon. And that's right out in front. Eden looking for something. He's maybe double up his score line, but not quite. That puck sits in the ice and then goes back and forth. Not quite an offside, and then eventually just turned over to the Admirals. It's Chamberlain's going to take a hard angle wrister looking for a deflection. He got it, but the secondary shot was knocked away. The Admirals with a good opportunity there, but nothing doing. That's out to neutral. One-on-one, Chris Eden's going to go up against another shot, and wrister doesn't get anything to it. That was frustrating for him, but Gareth McLeish took a very good angle and had a great defensive play there to make sure that it was nothing but a wrister that Kirk Camagos saw the whole way in. 1-1 the score, and we're going to stay that way for a little bit here because of that good defensive play. Face-off won by Orr. Out to Brown. Back in front. Or collects for just a moment, then Fontaine. Fontaine doing a pretty good job of hustling and skating hard today. Turned into the corner. That's flipped up and out. Red Devils looking for a clearance penalty. I don't think they're going to get a delay a game here, but certainly was a question asked. So we'll see. Yes, there it is. So immediately played out over the high glass, so a delay of game against the Admirals. And who's going to serve that one? That's going to be Jordan Chalice is going to serve for the Admirals. 2 minutes on the board. Just under 5 minutes to go here in the second. Long shot in by Graham. And that's knocked aside by the pads, and the Red Devils have to reset. Brown's got it. Little bit of a forecheck, but that's not going to affect them too much. They're trying to skate down an icing call, and unfortunately Brown took a long shot out to Hayden Boole, and Boole couldn't quite touch it, and therefore icing coming up, so it's going to allow the Admirals to switch up and get the four fresh sets of legs out there. Minute 43 still on the power play, so not a lot gone. But the Devils are going to be fighting out of their defensive end to start with Daigle to take the faceoff for the Admirals. Puck dropped through the linesman's legs. Perver wins it. Dallimore deciding what to do with it here for a moment. And there's the delay of game call. And that's turned over for a shorthanded opportunity. Shot in. That was luckily deflected because Reason was in a bad spot there. And he gets bailed out by his defense. Brown gets knocked off his feet there, although manages to stay on his skates. And another thing is upended by Henry. It's a rough afternoon. Right out in front, Daigle's not going to have his, but Henry takes a shot in, and a weird bounce. Another opportunity for the Admirals, but nothing doing. That pass is going to go straight onto the goal, so no icing there. The Red Devils, once the puck goes all the way down to Eden, and they get a lot of fresh legs out on the ice. 43 seconds to go on the power play. Eden holds on to it, ready to set up the move on this power play. That's gives that up, and off go the five men in red. And Tappan knocks it in behind the net. That puck's held for just a moment, sent around. Out to the point. Eden's going to hold on to it for just a moment. Looking for Fontaine on the other point. He holds on to it. He's going to push it forward, and then he looks back, goes back down to the blue line out to Eden on the other side. Eden looking for a pass, bounces off the opponent, sends it back. Fontaine with a goal out of a great pass by Eden, goes all the way across, and Jackson Fontaine, the international from the Red Devils, makes it a 2-1 game, a long shot. And as that's passed across the ice, he takes a one-timer and beats Kirkomagos to his left as he was moving right. Just caught him forward, a little bit back, leaning,
back
playing a
line,
bit
Eden
too positional, and just got it right by
pass.
Him. That was a fantastic goal.
Opponent,
Jackson Fontaine, second
Fontaine
point
with
for
a goal!
Chris Eden today.
He's going to push it forward, and then he looks back.
Jackson Fontaine played for the Mako against the Auckland teams earlier. And got his first goal last home game here. He got a goal against the Stampede, so he's had himself a good start to the season. Well done, Mr. Fontaine. Devils get the puck. They've got the lead for the first time this afternoon with just under 2.5 to go in the second. And we'll see how the Admirals react to the fact that they've given up the last two goals. That's turned over and held in. Dallimore flips it into the corner. Graham gives it up. Reese has got to play back. Ellis is going to take it. Ellis knocks it forward into the offensive zone for the Admirals. He gets it back, looking for a shot. Reason has no idea where it is. He's looking behind him all over the place. Goal eventually does come off its moorings. Play stopped. But it looks like it was under Reason's leg. And Dan Reason with a very fortunate scenario where he did make the save, whether he felt it or not. And the score remains 2-1. Spark Business Hub, Christchurch. Thank you, Spark Business, for sponsoring the 2022 Canterbury Red Devils. We appreciate your support and your longtime sponsorship. Won by the Admirals there for just a moment. They hold on to it deep in the Red Devil zone. Nobody quite sure whether to take the zone or man play there, and the Admirals hold on to the puck for quite a bit. Nothing really dangerous yet, but looking for setting up a pass. That shot goes behind, more of a kind of a positional shot. Out to Hayward Jones. He's got his stick knocked away, so that shot was off target because of that. And passed around on the boards. Dodwell flipping it out to neutral and relieving the pressure. Sisho off the bench. Line change, Eden coming back out. And some fresh legs for the Devils to finish up this second period. Daigle with a pass. Doesn't gain the zone immediately. And that caused the Admirals to have to clear. Dodwell with it to Eden. Eden's going to take a wrister. And a solid save by Kirkomagos as he gloves it and holds on to it at a very key time for the Admirals. Very active second part of this second period. The offense coming for the Devils finally, and two goals on the board already. as the Devils have taken the lead back. Tapping with it at the point. He can't get it through. He's got to recollect. Goes out to neutral. Passes it across. And the Devils reset. Eden's out of the zone looking for the puck, but he couldn't get a hold of it. Turned over. Admirals at neutral and kicked around. That was Josh Lowe getting it out of the zone. Nobody quite controlling it right up until that point, and that was Joe Orr with a hold of it. Back out to Chamberlain. Chamberlain's going to gain the zone 2-on-2 for the Admirals, but he can't really make anything of it. They cycle around. Good forechecking on the shots. That was a very good shot. And a good save by Reason. I actually was concerned that got behind him where that was at, but he flashed the leather, holds on to it in the glove, and we continue 2-1. Officially on the board, there's 3 seconds to go. So not much going on here, but Chamberlain's going to get another opportunity. Now, remember, in the first period, this was the exact moment when somebody took a tripping penalty. So fortunately, this time around, 3 seconds go by, and we don't give up a penalty in this case. So an excellent period for the Red Devils, getting 2 goals on the board, taking the lead, and really just getting used to what's going on with the Admirals, figuring out their defense, and getting some opportunities to take the lead and put the Red Devils in a good spot. Now, with that being said, the last two games that were played here, this is going to really define what kind of season we've got for the Red Devils, in my opinion, because the home weekend here, we had the Sky City Stampede and had a lead going into each of the second periods for both of those games. The Devils were outscored 7-0 cumulatively with the third period against the Stampede, losing both of those games, and that's where they're at right now. You turn that around, they're first place in the league. So two bad periods last time around 3 weeks ago were a tough pill to swallow for the Red Devils. If they can get that sorted and get the ship righted here and put one away, at least one of them away here for the with the Admirals, it would make a huge difference in where they stand in the rankings for the NZIHL. So we'll come back to you here in a few minutes. Fontaine and Eden with the tallies this period. I'm sure you're seeing the videos as they go by. And then we're going to give you about 10 minutes of a break here for the second intermission. And we'll come back to you here in Christchurch to watch some more NZIHL here on YouTube. Thank you, everybody.
That does go out to neutral to Dallimore. He's going to gain the zone. Move in on the right side. Takes a long shot in. Matt Graham skates close, but nothing doing. Kirk Camagos away. That does go out to neutral to Dallimore. He's going to gain the zone. Move in on the right side. Takes a long shot in. Matt Graham skates close, but nothing doing. Kirk Camagos weathering the storm in the first 8 minutes of this second period to starting to take over just a little bit. Long pass out. This is going to be an opportunity. Shot and a score. Weathering the storm in the first 8 minutes of this second period to starting to take over just a little bit. Long pass out. This is going to be an opportunity. Shot and a score. He's going to push it forward, and then he looks back, goes back down to the blue line out to Eden on the other side. Eden looking for a pass, bounces off the opponent, sends it back. Fontaine with a goal out of. He's going to push it forward, and then he looks back, goes back down to the blue line out to Eden on the other side. Eden looking for a pass, bounces off the opponent, sends it back. Fontaine with a goal out of. A great pass by Eden.
Kia ora koutou. Welcome back, everybody, to the Alpine Ice Sports and Entertainment Center. Yeah, you are seeing some figure skating here just in front of the third period. Good time to recap a few things for you. wanted to go through the official stats. First goal, Max Vesper. That was a power play goal. Justin Daigle and Alex Regan with the assists on that. And then Chris Eden had a single assist with Dan Nichols for his equalizer on the breakaway. And then the one-timer from Jackson Fontaine, that's still the one that surprised me. That was such a great far-angle shot. Had no idea he was actually going to pull that one off, but he did. Jackson with the two assists going to Chris Eden, and then Luke Tappan also with an assist on that play. That should get the scoring up to date. 2-1 is the score. The Red Devils are in the lead. You can find on the NZIHL page a link to the IIHF live scoring. If you're interested in doing that, they do keep a live score stat sheet available for those of you that were interested in the exact scoring and power plays and so forth, in case you want to keep up on that. Otherwise, we've got ourselves quite a third period coming up with what will really be a barn burner here. The opportunity for the Devils to I can't even imagine at this point. When's the last time we were thinking about the Red Devils being a winning team after five games? This is a big one in the face-off and a quick shot. As we get right underway, Jackson Fontaine with one over the pipe, but very close. Kirk Comagos already under fire here on the third. Fontaine pushing and kicking his way to try to get to the puck, but the Admirals managed to get that out to neutral, one on two, disrupted, and turned right back around. Fontaine got a stick on that. That should not have been an icing, but it was indeed called icing. I would have sworn right in front of me that I saw it hit him, but I don't think anybody else did, so that's going to go all the way back for an Admirals face-off in the offensive zone and see what they can do to see if they can get something quickly on the board and tie this one up just 30 seconds into the third. Face-off won by the Devils. Eden's got it. He's going to push that back out to Fontaine. Fontaine gains the zone. It's a wrister in, just not quite on target, but Kirk Komagos watched that one go flying by over his right shoulder. Not by much. I'm sure he knew he had it, but that shot was a pretty good one. Eden flips it in, and the offense clicking for the Devils at the moment. Graham trying to chase it down, but doesn't because Nichols is going to play. That was deflected, goes all the way back. They're going to have to chase. And Josh Lowe with it for the moment. Nichols out of the zone. All the way up to Dallimore. Dallimore's going to have a one-on-one. He's going to see if he can get a shot off. Can't do it. Great defense. That was Mason Kennedy. Another former Red Devil making good on that one. Right out in front, Perver with a shot. That might have been one of the more dangerous opportunities. Perver just looking at a puck sitting in the slot. Jumps up on it, can't quite get it high enough, and Kirk Komagos gloves it for the stop. Just a very turbo session of 85 seconds into the third period. We're doing a quick one here. Everybody jumping, trying to get something going here and getting a first step on the first period. Graham with a wrister, but that's deflected all the way out. And Brown collects it when the Devils in charge, looking for a long pass. That's going to go for icing if Matt Graham can't get there, but he actually was winning the race, so no icing. Big hit. That was Gareth McLeish with a solid wipeout of Matt Graham. I think Matt saw it coming, but he went through it anyways, and that disrupted the play, so good play all around. Chamberlain bringing it up the left side. He's hacked down, not really penalty, just pushed to the side. And as that goes up against the boards, the Admiral's trying to keep a hold of it. Can't do it, goes out to neutral. Sent in off sides. Nichols going to control it. Out to neutral for a moment. Seichel got run over there. Regan with it. He's going to take it all the way through. No, it's passed back. Good drop pass, but just didn't get anything on it, and then the Devils control. Seichel gets it in. That was a shot, but it was off Ellis into the corner, and they cycle through here. The puck goes out to neutral, and the Devils are going to have to reset, but looking good so far. They gain the zone, throw it around. Admirals control. They get it back out. Hopkins with it. And the Devils have to reset. A little bit of trivia for you. I think it was Hopkins is the CIHA head youth coach here. Random trivia fact for you for the day. And that puck gets sent all the way around. The Admirals are going to hold on to it for just a... Oh, no, it's turned over. And a good solid hit. Orr's going to flip it forward. Gets it into the slot, but nobody home. And that cycled back through. Orr gets in front of it again. But that goes out into the middle area and into the neutral ice. Quick wrister in. There's a little bit of zip on that one. That was Josh Lowe taking a shot for no particular reason, and there's nobody going to guard him, so he may as well take one. Didn't quite walk it in as much as he may have been able to, but nonetheless, glove save and a stop. The offense gets another opportunity with Perver to take this faceoff for the Devils. Wins it. But that goes out to neutral. They got to reset. Nichols throws it all the way in. Kirk Komagos gloves it down just to keep play going. And the Admirals break out 3-on-3. They gain the zone. Try to wrist it in. That's lifted and behind the net. Daigle with it. He shoots. He scores. Daigle. 2-2 the score. Justin Daigle with the, he was really taking a blind shot there. I know this because I was on the same eye line that he had looking at Reason. He saw nothing. He just shot it towards the net. And I'm sure Reason didn't see it coming with all the traffic between him. And 2-2's the score. A fantastic hockey goal to take a chance there. And it paid off for Daigle and evens the score. So we're back underway. Back and forth in neutral. Ping pong back and forth. Henry with it for a moment. But the Devils get it back to neutral. Tylan to hold on to it. No, he's going to let that go. To Lowe. Lowe flips it forward, gets it in the slot, turned over, but the Admirals hold on to it. That gets flipped out into their bench. It was from the defensive side, so I'm not sure where that faceoff is going to come from, but 2-2 the score, and the Admirals doing a great job of neutralizing what had been an offensive advantage for the Devils. A couple extra shots, a couple of good shots, but in the end, the only point that goes on the board is the one for the goal for the Admirals and Justin Daigle. Puck controlled by nobody in particular, but Orr's got it for now. He's trying to get it out in front. Can't get anything on it with Eden in front. He gets to the corner looking for a pass. He turns around. It's the circle on the PlayStation button. Sends it through. Another. That was a dangerous shot as that went low and hard by Lowe. Sorry about the pun, but it worked out. And that carries around. Josh Lowe gets it out to Orr, who gets it out of the zone, gets it up to Eden. Eden's looking for a pass. That's deflected, unfortunately, for him, but it stays in. And the puck cycles in the far corner. Another long shot by Lowe. That's gloved and stopped, and play will hold as the puck gets stopped in Kurt Komagos' glove. Everybody changes up. Reason's getting making snow angels on his end. And a bit of a surprise, just
on three,
a little over 5 minutes into the third.
Try to
we are tied
in.
Up 2-2 the score. Good, good
the
game this afternoon.
Daigle with it. He shoots, he scores. Daigle.
And we're going to see what should be a good finish here. That was Vesper with it going through. He had an opportunity but couldn't quite get anything on it. Back to neutral. Dodwell had it for just a moment. Now it's back to the Admirals. Ellis. And then it goes back to Hayden Bull. Admirals game the zone there. Chalice with it. Goes through the slot. Not really controlled by the Devils, but... that goes all the way into the corner, and they're going to dig for it. Ellis with a turnaround wrister. Goes off Reason's shoulder. And then back out to neutral. The Admirals with a win on that particular shift, and Ellis is going to stay out and double. He's going to flip it around and look for it to come back to him. Doesn't quite get back to him. And Matt Graham with it. He's going to go out to neutral, look for the long pass. He gets it to Dallimore. Dallimore's got to play up against the boards. And that's flipped back out to neutral. They reset. Not quite turned over. Now it is turned over to the Admirals, but flipped back out to neutral. Back and forth. And Graham's going to go 1-on-3. He gets a good pass off to Dallimore. Dallimore takes a shot. Knocked around. Nichols is going to go control it, and that is going to be icing. Between Graham and Dallimore, a couple of good opportunities, or good hustle plays, really. They weren't really scary for the Admirals, but a couple of good hustle plays end up paying off and getting an offensive faceoff coming up for the Devils here in the third. 7 minutes down and an even score on the board. Faceoff won by the Admirals here. And as they push through, they've got a 2-on-3. Trying to get something going. Gets a shot all the way through. Who was that? That was an excellent run by, was it Scott Henry? Yeah, it was. First time calling his name in a while. And a great charge through, playing through a man down and got something on Reason there. We continue on. The puck is behind Reason's net, and the Admirals continue the offense. Finally, it's turned over, and the Devils get it out to neutral. Sent right back in by the Admirals, but they are going to get a a line change while they can. And the Devils set up, and they're probably going to look to do the same here, depending on how this breaks out. That gets all the way to neutral. And they can't get off the ice. That passed all the way over for the Admirals to Strong with it. He holds on to it. So Strong throws it at the net, doesn't quite get it on target, but the Devils pass it around, get it out to neutral. Eden's going to walk it in and turn right back over. That's going to go for an icing call, and that's going to be a big benefit for the Devils. They had some tired legs out there, and they're going to get a change while pinning the Admirals 5 on the ice. Game's tightened up a little bit here with the reluctance to make any big mistakes. The offensive opportunities have kind of closed up the last 4 minutes here since the second goal by the Admirals. Faceoff won by the Admirals. They're going to drag that out. Regan with it. He's going to go hard, take a shot. That gets blocked by Mason Reese. Reese with a good effort there defensively, and the Devils pick out the puck and get it out to neutral to get going on the on their defensive end. Turned over, Chamberlain with it. He's going to dipsy doodle and get, beats two guys, which is pretty handy stick work. But Graham's going to get a hold of it eventually, and he is going to turn it around. That's going to go for icing. Nobody was looking, and there it is. Called icing against the Devils, so faceoff coming in the offensive zone for the Admirals. Spark Business Hub, Christchurch, Cedra Express, Majors Contracting, Aotearoa Gaming Trust, Fisher and Spinorama, and Access Solutions, all of our partners in the 2022 season. We really like to thank everybody for being sponsors for the Red Devils this year. Couldn't do it without you. We really appreciate it. That puck goes all the way up to Dalmore. Dalmore's come a bit of a dipsy doodle and holding on to it, and doesn't quite get a shot, but a lot of effort there. And 1-on-3 in the back check. So that's going to hold Vesper out and gets knocked up against the board, wiped out a little bit. Graham's going to get to the puck. And then that goes back to Dan Nichols. Nichols not quite able to get a hold of it, but that top line doing their best to neutralize where the Admirals are at. That goes out to neutral. Flipped away. Eden's going to forecheck, but for the most part, they're going out to line 2 for the Devils. And the Admirals looking to break out. Nichols breaks up that play at neutral. And that pass a little bit errant for Joe Orr. Eden collects it, though. He's hauled down. No call. Looking for a hold, but nothing there. Ellis with it. 1-on-2. Ellis is going to take it in. Take a shot. That goes to the glass in the back. Brown's going to grab it. Pull it back. looked like Josh Lowe took his eyes off it for a moment, and Ellis almost collected that, but worked out okay for the Devils. That's not going to go for icing. And bit of a change in the back end for the Devils, but the forechecking doing a good job holding up the Admirals, not letting them break out at all. Flip forward. Well, that was heavily deflected away and goes out to neutral again. Henry's got it for the Admirals as they try to set up some sort of offense. The Devils looking for a quick clearance. Hayden Poole doing his best to hold on to things. A glove goes flying for the Admirals there, picked up and out to neutral. And that was Kaluzny with it for just a moment. Keep forgetting, Kaluzny doesn't have a nameplate yet. He's number 44 on the sheet. That puck goes all the way in. That was not icing, so I guess it was just far enough forward. And George Hopkins doing his best to move that around. Doesn't quite get out. This is a bit interesting. Again, some zone clearance problems in the third period for the Devils. Not nearly what they've had in the past, but still noticeable. Chamberlain with it. He's going to take a shot in right in on Reason. No gaps at all. No chance. So Chamberlain gets the shot in, but Reason holds on to it and freezes the puck as time goes flying right by. We're under 9 minutes to go here in a very tight hockey game. This is a good one this afternoon here at the Alpine Ice in Christchurch. Devils win this faceoff. Graham with it. He's going to pass it around. I think that's Reese with it. All the way forward. That might go for icing if it's not. Yeah, Graham doing his best to get there but can't do it. That was a stretch pass that didn't quite go right. So the icing called on the Devils. Chalice to take this one for the Admirals. He wins it. That shot goes up and over immediately. That was Hayward Jones with a slap shot that was deflected up and out. So we're going to do it all over again. Chalice beats low with that. That shot goes off into the corner and again deflected up into the netting. So we'll do it a third time. Although I think it's going to come on to the other side. We'll see here. Nope. Same spot. Near side to the camera. Chalice is up again. One of the linesmen almost tripped over the blue line. That was interesting. And the Admirals continue with the puck. Flipped out close to the point, but doesn't get out. And that's Reese with it. Reese doing what he can, but maintained by the Admirals. Out in the slot, and a shot, a dangerous shot in, a second one. Reason knocks it down. That apparently stayed in. That was knocked down directly by one of the Admirals players. And the Devils doing what they can to get out to neutral. They finally do. And Dallimore's got it. He's going to take a shot in. A strategic choice there as he was skating away, but still took a shot in. Kirk Omagos has to glove it and hold on to it, which is in itself a strategic win for the Devils, getting fresh players on the ice and an offensive faceoff coming up with under 8 minutes to go. This is a tight one coming down to the end. Perver to take this one, 2-2 the score. Devils win that one. Eden with a long shot in, that's deflected. Another quick little wrister and didn't quite come off, but Jackson Fontaine with an excellent opportunity. Eden with a shot. Missed the target, goes around. Nichols is not going to be able to hold it in on the point there, but he gets a hold of it anyway, sends it into the near corner. Perver's going to play that up against the boards. Hayward Jones not able to do anything with it, and the Admirals, well, they get a hold of it, and they try to break out, but they don't actually clear the zone yet until they get to Taylor Kennedy, which they just did. And then that goes behind Reese's net. Turned over low for the Admirals, a shot in that was not quite on target, but a dangerous one for the Devils, having troubles clearing their zone again. Taylor Kennedy holding that one in on the point. And just like a magnet, the puck seems to be tilted a little bit down towards the left side here, or the right side as the camera looks. Sorry, it's a... I'm on the other end this time. Shot in. And a heavy, heavy shot by Jackson Fontaine. Kirk Omagos up to the task, holding on to it. But Jackson Fontaine getting all of that one. And not quite where he wanted it, but pretty good-looking shot. And the best opportunity so far in the third for the Devils. Hayden Boole to take this one for the Devils. Face-off one. To low, to Boole. Boole flips around, tries to hold on to it. And then Lowe's got to play it. He's going to take it through neutral, walk it up. Gains the zone. Plays his man. Loses the puck just for a minute, and the Admirals get a hold of it. And the Admirals continue defensively to do a good job in their zone. Oh, that's right out in front. Dumped up. It was a bad turnover. And the Devils almost took advantage of it, not able to get anything on it, just in a weird spot. But they hold on to it. Long, slow shot in. Not sure who that was. I think that was Josh Lowe with the kind of the loopy high shot. Kirk Omagos has to glove it, and that's going to let 10 guys change here. Another 2 minutes off the clock of a little bit of a neutral back and forth, but the Still, the Fontaine opportunity another solid chance for the Devils. And Lowe loses that faceoff, turns over to the Admirals, and as Vesper sends it up the left side, Ellis gets a hold of it, Vesper back to it, and there's a penalty coming up. That's against the Admirals whenever it comes up. That's going to be a 6-on-5 for the moment. Dallimore's got it. He's going to do what he can to get a shot off before this penalty gets called. And there it is. That's the whistle. Looks like it was a holding call. Let's see if I can get a number for you on that one. But that was... Vesper. It was Vesper. You know, it's funny. He came through and he was hustling so hard. I think he just got called for a hook there. But we'll get that officially in just a moment. But that was a very interesting hustle play that really kind of surprised he gave that up. Face-off won by the Admirals. They're going to kill some time. They're going to have an opportunity here. Henry's all the way down the ice. Reason with an excellent stop there on a shorthanded opportunity, catching the Devils sleeping here. Did a great job of just firing down the ice and nobody defensively ready for him. Unfortunately for Henry, not quite as good a shot as the rest of the play, and we continue on 2-2. Eden's got it. He's checked for just a moment, but the Devils hold on to the puck. The Admirals, four on the blue line here, waiting for that to come in. Nichols cycles through, and that's going to come in off the right side. Orr's got it. He's going deep in the corner, then back out to Eden. Eden's going to hold on to it for a moment, think about what to do. Admirals in a box, playing a little high, but not too high, as they're not really pressuring the blue line. That gets tipped all the way down. No icing here, of course. Collected. It's actually not quite a shot, but it was disruptive enough. And the Admirals continue to chew up time. 49 seconds to go. Still some heavy forechecking by, I think that was Chamberlain there, killing some desperate moments for the Devils. But they're going to get that out to neutral and reset. Pass across the rink. Dallimore's got it. He's going to sit on it for a minute. Let everybody set up. Now the high box comes in from the Admirals. Now they compress. Shot into the slot. Nothing doing. Sent all the way back down. 20 seconds to go on the power play. Devils recollect. They're going to try and get something going here. And try to get an opportunity on this man advantage. But so far, with 10 seconds to go, nothing happening. That's going to come up the side. Tappan's got it. He's up the right. He's looking for a pass. Goes back to Eden, and Vesper is out of the box. That stayed onside, shot in. Kirkamagos holds on to Eden's shot, and there's going to be a faceoff, but we are back to 5-on-5 hockey. Officially 3 minutes, 14 seconds to go, and this one's getting to a very tense conclusion here, as the Devils not really able to get much off on that that power play. The Admirals had the best of them for the last 2 minutes, with the exception of one decent shot. Admirals win that faceoff. Tipped around. And 1-on-2 coming up for the Admirals as they gain this own shot in. Reason stretches, but that was never on target. 4 players over in the sideboards. Chalice looking to hold it in, but he can't. That gets dumped out to neutral. The Devils looking to play a little bit defensively here. I think they're looking for a line change, but they've got 4 back. And the Admirals gain the zone. Hayward Jones, and then a shot. A dangerous shot. Reason with a good glove save there. The Admirals are circling and look like they are going to loiter with intent. Regan with a long shot in. That's another good save by Reason, keeping that out. Shot by Hayward Jones. That's deflected before it gets to Reason. And that's going to go for icing if it's not caught. And there's the icing. So the Devils looking particularly on the back foot here in the last minute. A dangerous opportunity for the Admirals to try to steal this one on the road. which would be very disappointing for the Red Devils, having a couple of good offensive opportunities and a couple of good goals and taking the lead here. This is a big moment for the Red Devils season. Face-off won by the Admirals. Shot in. Reason can't reach it. It was behind him anyways. Goes to Graham. Graham can't get it out. He gets his stick lifted, and that puck comes in. Shot against Reason, and a good one. A good save. That was Justin Daigle again, getting a good opportunity up against Reason with a tough angle, but a quick skate towards the net. And luckily, Reason was up to it with just under 2 minutes to go. Faceoff coming in the defensive zone for the Red Devils. Puck dropped and won by the Devils, and that's going to get – does it get to neutral? Yes, it does. Henry's going to collect it for the Admirals, sends it through. Tappan's going to get it and backhand it to Eden. Eden can't get it out. But then it does – no, it still doesn't come to neutral, but officially – well, that's okay. It goes to Fontaine. Fontaine's going to knock it around. No icing here. The Admirals collect and look at the their opportunity to break out. That's kept in, kicked in very well by the Devils, but then it goes right back out. Daigle's going to get a hold of it. He's behind Reasons now. He's going to skate around looking for something. Gets something through the slot, untouched for too long, but the Devils turn it around. Tap in with a very dangerous shot, eye level. Kirk Omagos almost didn't get to that. It looked like it caught between his ear and his shoulder. Long shot in. That's deflected down and goes out of the zone. Two-on-three opportunity for the Admirals. And they hold on to it. We're under a minute to go in this hockey game. It's going to come down to the last moments no matter what. Now, the Admirals have the puck. They escape behind Reason's net. Kicked around, and it just comes right out in front to Reason. Reason does the conservative thing and puts his glove on it. Face-off coming in the defensive zone with just over 40 seconds to go for the third period of regulation play. Timeout called, and I think this is a good one. Yeah, the Red Devils called the timeout there, 30-second timeout, and probably a really good choice by the head coach, Anatoly Korozov. And the Anatoly's also the national coach for the Ice Blacks. so he was well accustomed to making good strategic decisions. This is definitely a good one here. Giving
the other side.
Devils an opportunity
Eden
to rest for just a second and get this
off
one
the
right.
Opponent, sends it back. Fontaine with a goal!
On the score clock. May say a little something different
forward,
on the screen, but it is
back.
On the,
back on the
scoreboard,
blue line out to Eden 42.5
seconds to go to finish up this third period. And, of course, there's if it goes to OT, it's 3-on-3 for 5 minutes, then a shootout. And that'll be the that'll be if we get to zeros here. Face-off won by the Admirals, but stolen away. Matt Graham with it. He's got an opportunity to win this one. Can't get the shot off. Kirk Omagos comes out of his net and makes a great play. Fantastic opportunity. Vesper with it. And everybody going for it here. Ellis is going to get to this puck first for the Admirals. Keeps it in. But just for a minute. And that's passed out. Matheson Graham looking for the pass. Daigle back to Graham and kicked away. Now there's a 3-on-2 coming up for the Admirals here. 3 seconds to go. Shot in. Reason holds on to it. And they're going to get a face-off here. Officially, well, they're going to let the clock go out, but I don't think that's the case. They're going to fix it. They're going to put 1 second on the clock. I'm listening in here on the scoreboard. So they're going to put 1 second on the clock officially. And that is the right call. They did run the clock after that. The faceoff will be in the defensive zone. Excuse me. And that is going to give... surprisingly, Kirk Omagos is going back out there. I would have assumed that they would have gone 6-on-5 here for the... Admirals, but they're not. So I don't think they're expecting anything to happen here. So just a everybody lining up. They're going to drop the puck, and that's that. And that is the horn. Apparently they counted this. I think it started counting upwards on the scoreboard. But nonetheless, third period over. And we are stuck 2-2. And that's fine. I think they said that's the third period. The referee and linesman are over there talking, and I'm trying to find out what's going on, but I am pretty sure that that ends the third period, and we're going to go to overtime here. Waiting to feel. So officially it's going to be an overtime. It'll be 3-on-3 hockey to see if we can get a winner. So those of you who are used to North American hockey, there's a bit of a different rule in the IIHF. If you're playing at this league, it's each team has won a point now. So in the North American leagues, if you play, you're playing for 2 points for a win, but you get 1 point if you get into overtime. So that's the same, but the way it works here is it's a 3-2-1-0. So the winning team that's going to come out of here, whether it's in overtime or in the shootout, will get 2 points in the standings, and the other team will get 1 point, which is going to be significant given the closeness of where everybody stands in these standings. This is it's a big point. It's a big point for this afternoon. So we'll see how this turns out. I'll be back with you in just a second here. And the three on the ice for each team. Let's just see if we can get some numbers here. It looks like Fontaine, Eden, and Nichols playing 2-1 for the Devils. Ellis is on the ice along with... Well, let's see. Well, Ellis has got it now. He's going to drive in on Reason. Reason knocks that away. Fontaine gets it to Eden. Eden gains the zone, looking for his line mate there. He passes it around. Fontaine's going to collect it, sends it back to Eden. Lots of space out there at the moment. Eden looking to make a move individually. He's kind of stuck in the corner. He's going to get that out to Nichols. And that's turned over. The Admirals looking to break out on their 3-on-3. They're going to get a change and gain the zone. Turned over. There's going to be an opportunity here. Matt Graham with an opportunity to close it out. Misses the goal. Back to Orr. Orr couldn't get a shot off on that second choice there. And then Brown with it. Long shot in. Kirko Magos falls down. And then it looks like it was... Was that Brown that was knocked on his backside? No, that was Orr that took that one. And Kirko Magos holding on to it for a faceoff. An always exciting five-minute overtime. The scoring opportunities come very quickly. So Orr's going to take this one for the Devils. And we'll see if they can get an opportunity here. That's out to Brown. Brown's going to move it across. He looks for a pass. That goes straight up into the lights, comes right back down. And Brown's got to take it out of the zone. He's going to get pressured, but he turns around, does a great job. And Orr is offsides as he was hacked by a stick there, but he's looking for a call. He's not going to get it. Looked incidental to me, but that was the question. So we continue 3-on-3. Of course, if there was a penalty, we go 4-on-3, which is a bit of an oddity, but it is what it is for overtime hockey. It's maths. So turned over, 2-on-1 opportunity for the Admirals. Chamberlain with it. He tries to get a pass across to his teammate, but can't do it. That goes out to neutral. And here comes Chamberlain up the left side again with a lot of speed. He's going to take a shot. Reason's right there to hold on to it. And pinches it between his legs and nothing doing. Face-off coming. Everybody switching. The key to the three-on-three is fresh legs every time you can get them, because it's a lot of skating. So all six players change up. Chalice going to take this one along with Ellis out there and Hayward Jones. Hayward Jones gets it knocked away for just a second, which was critical for the Devils. Graham's going to play into that corner, try to get that dug out, but he can't. Sent out, and Ellis is going to have to chase. That's going to go all the way down to Kirkomagos. He's going to hold it up for Ellis. And the Admirals set up shop, 3-on-3. Pass behind that goes up a skate. Fortunate bounce. Shot by Ellis. Missed everything. Chalice got it. He's going to hold it on the point and move it across for a moment. Looks for a pass. Gets it back to Chalice. Reason in a good spot. Oh, and that just hit the net, but it hit the outside netting. And he holds on to the puck. Chalice with it, looking for somebody to help. Hayward Jones with a knocking it down back to Chalice. He's behind the net again. That puck skips and hops out to neutral. And the Red Devils get the relief they need with three fresh players back out on the ice. The Admirals looking to hold on to it and maybe set something up, but the they may be also looking for a change. They got two players off. Moved across and then out to neutral. And that's stolen away from Orr. Eden's looking to pull it away, and Brown finally gets in the way. Eden's going to come up the right side. He looks for a long pass, tape to tape. He does it off to Orr. Orr's going to take a shot just over the crossbar. And play stopped because that was deflected and up into the netting. But one of the best opportunities of the afternoon to close it out. Orr can't quite get it over the shoulder. Knocked up by Kirkomagos into the netting. And the Admirals live to fight on for a little bit longer. Remaining in the overtime period on the board is it's 144 on the board. Sisho to take the pace off for the Devils. And he loses that one, but Eden's going to go chase that puck. It goes out to the Admirals. Nichols is going to put a body check on. That works for a moment, but then the Admirals get it in, then out, then in. Now Eden's got it in neutral. He's going to do a nice move to get himself into the offensive end and hold on to the puck. He's doing a great job against Daigle individually. Steps forward, takes a shot, and goal! He did it! Chris Eden wins the game for the Red Devils. An outstanding individual play coming out of the corner, beat his man, roofed the puck over Kirkomagos. 3-2 the score, and the final goes to the Red Devils in overtime. What a game, what a change for the season. The Red Devils with a winning record a month in. What a nice thing to be saying right about now. The Admirals, fantastic afternoon of hockey, and they do walk away with a point. Fantastic game by them as well. One of the better NZIHL games I've seen in a few years. Well played, tightly played, smart ice hockey all the way around, but it turns out the Devils got the best of them today. And the best part about all of it, tomorrow at the same time, you tune in, we'll give you another one of these. Handshakes all around. Final score in overtime. The Canterbury Red Devils 3, the West Auckland Admirals 2. And you'll be seeing some replays and things, highlights going on the broadcast. But in the meantime, we're going to get out of here and wish you a fantastic afternoon from Christchurch, New Zealand. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. We will see you tomorrow at exactly the same time.
Cycle
same two teams, same
Admirals.
Location. We'll see you then.
Ellis with the shot. That was
IHL on YouTube.
Up into the
we'll
glass.
See you tomorrow. Cheers.
Daigle with a drag. And a goal. Vesper with it. The Daigle shot goes off of Reason. Nobody there to take Vesper at the body, and he gets a close-in shot
for the Admirals.
Ellis with a shot. That was off the shoulder and up into the glass. Daigle with a drag. And a goal. Vesper with it. The Daigle shot goes off of Reason. Nobody there to take Vesper at the body, and he gets a close in weathering shot. The storm in the first 8 minutes of this second period to starting to take over just a little bit. Long pass out. This is going to be an opportunity. Shot and a score. Weathering the storm in the first 8 minutes of this second period to starting to take over just a little bit. Long pass out. This is going to be an opportunity. Shot and a score. He's going to push it forward, and then he looks back, goes back down to the blue line out to Eden on the other side. Eden looking for a pass, bounces off the opponent, sends it back. Fontaine with a goal out of. He's going to push it forward, and then he looks back, goes back down to the blue line out to Eden on the other side. Eden looking for a pass, bounces off the opponent, sends it back. Fontaine with a goal out of. A great pass. Try to wrist it in. That's lifted and behind the net. Daigle with it. He shoots. He scores. Daigle. Three. They gain the zone. Try to wrist it in. That's lifted and behind the net. Daigle with it. He shoots. He scores. Daigle.